we don't know that they're not arbitrary at this point.
It would just be interesting to see if we could also measure that and say.
Yeah.
I've been working with Katherine Moore. She was my teacher for the archaeology of animals. Thereafter, I went to the field with her to learn how to study faunal remains from archaeological sites. The research that I'm conducting in the CAAM laboratories is focused upon understanding the domestication of pigs by analyzing molar shape differences in archaeological specimens. After working at the University of Pennsylvania New Bolton Center, studying pig behavior and dealing with pigs from a veterinary perspective, I developed an interest in the species, and I was happy to continue working with them in further research.
When she told me that she knew more about pigs than I did, all kinds of things opened up for me because I had a sample here of ancient pigs from a very important site in Iran that I knew had a lot of research potential. The questions that she first asked when she came in to look at this material for the first time opened my eyes to things that I hadn't thought about.
Our hypothesis is that domesticated individuals will have a very different shape in their molar form teeth compared to wild individuals. In domestic pigs, we will see a crowding of teeth and a crowding of the structures in the teeth, and therefore that will be different from the wild type specimen.
We just want to make sure that the mandibles are correctly positioned within the edge here of the plate. So if you just want to make sure that this is exactly how you want to see them on the radiographic image.
Because now all of the lingual sides are exposed and the buccal sides are facing the plate.
Katherine Morucci, who's working on the project on the evolution of pig domestication, needed to have some x-ray images of the mandibles and the teeth to acquire the data that she needed. So I was able to facilitate that for her. I'm one of the train operators of this x-ray system.
Having access to x-ray machinery has been crucial to our development with this project, and it's giving us an inside scoop on a lot of the material that we need for important information on understanding the age of these individuals.
Archaeology is all about discovery, and in the future, as we continue to teach and research with our students, we're hoping to really add a lot of data information about the key questions about the past. So this is very exciting for us at CAAM.
Undergraduate research is critical. It's a critical part of education at Penn because it helps students learn to manage and evaluate information, to put things together and compare new pieces of information to existing knowledge, to become better citizens, to become better teachers and practitioners, to become better leaders.
Working in the CAAM laboratories has helped me develop a better picture of my future. I now know that continuing this research is something that I want to do, and I hope to apply to veterinary dual degree PhD programs.